battery life goes, they all work pretty well. You know, the 3G will drain your battery a little bit faster, and the Verizon, you know, the Omnia also has Wi-Fi. But, you know, they all, I think, had reasonable battery life relative to other devices that are out right now that have similar features and everything. I think if you're, you know, a heavy-duty user, obviously the Windows Mobile platform is going to give you more options. And in addition to more options in terms of software that you can install and that kind of thing, when you look at the TouchWiz interface, so TouchWiz is basically this widget docking sidebar. And on all the phones, it's also on the unlocked Omni, but we don't really need to see that now. You've got this dock that you can hide on the left-hand side, and you can scroll up and down, and you've got these widgets, and then you can drag one out if you want to the home screen, and then you can use it from the home screen. So I've got this media player widget, and so I can listen to, this is a podcast I sideloaded via microSD card. Also, the Omnia has 8 gigs of flash memory built in and a microSD card, which makes it a bit more of a, you know, multimedia beast. And your photos and your videos and all that will load and play a little bit faster off the internal memory than they would off of an SD card. Although if you get a, you know, a class 6, I guess, high-speed SD card, that'll help a little bit. But anyway, so you've got your widgets on the side, but there's not a lot of customization you can do as far as, you know, beyond the widgets that come with it. Samsung's working to build a developer ecosystem to have new widgets, and they're working with the carriers as well. And so hopefully we'll see more and more of these widgets. For right now, you're kind of limited to, you know, what you have on the phone. And, you know, they function a little bit differently on the different devices. So on the T-Mobile, you can see the media player is an actual functioning media player, the music player. As you can see, I can play and I can skip and, you know, whatever. The messaging and IM widgets are just shortcuts. So if I hit the messaging widget, it'll take me to the messaging app. Whereas if I'm on the Omnia here, it's a little more advanced in terms of the functionality because it's digging into Windows Mobile. And so I can, if I can find the widget, so in the Omni, you've got a few more options. You've got a phone book widget, which you can put on the front page. You've got your wireless connections manager. So right here from the home screen, I can manage my Wi-Fi, my Bluetooth, you know, my phone connection also, which is, you know, can be kind of handy, especially if you're doing a lot of Wi-Fi stuff. You've still got the media player widget, which is nice. And then you can have more notifications in terms of messaging and that kind of stuff, which is kind of nice as well. But then you can also go into the settings, and if you want to, you can actually you can turn off the Samsung widget, and you can turn on something called the Samsung Today screen. And this is where having the little optical mouse can come in handy if you've got ham thumbs like I do. And so now you've got this totally different screen, which has kind of a combination of shortcut functionality and then some, you know, you've got your day and your date, and then you've got your messaging with little indicators letting you know how many messages you have unread and that kind of stuff. And then you can get down to your menu. And so it's nice, you've got a little more flexibility because you've got a full-on smartphone interface running underneath. And again, with the Eternity, it's the basic TouchWiz OS, but a little bit different than a little bit different than the T-Mobile version. Some of the same icons. Again, you've got the media player, the music player. You've got the slideshow widget, which I didn't show you on the T-Mobile, but you can flip through your photos. And then if you want, you can change your home screen. So we'll change it, and that's kind of neat. Bluetooth manager, you know, so slightly different. So hopefully we're going to see the whole TouchWiz thing mature a little bit and have more widgets coming out, both for the feature phones and for the smartphone. And then you'll probably see, you know, as you got a little bit of a taste of here, you'll see carrier-specific widgets. You know, so the AT&T TouchWiz widgets might be a little different than the T-Mobile ones. Aside from that, you know, minor differences in terms of the menu. You've got three choices down here on AT&T on the bottom the bottom row. We'll get the stuff out of the way. On the T-Mobile, you've got, you know, four choices. Minor differences. And then, you know, you go into the actual menu and you've got different services. AT&T has their AT&T Music, the mobile TV, as I mentioned, AT&T GPS, T-Mobile, you know, slightly different services. They've got their audio postcard thing. There, no online music store, you know, just a straight up music player. That sort of stuff. And then, you know, the phone's fairly similar in terms of functionality with multimedia. If we go into my stuff, we'll go to videos. I guess there's no videos loaded on the AT&T phone. The Omnia, again, steps it up. You've got actually support for DivX on the Omnia. So if you go to the Touch Player app, you can watch DivX videos. I think this is something that I recorded myself here. Yeah, this is, if you watch the Omnia unboxing video, I recorded the beginning of it with this phone.
Is the Samsung Omnia for Verizon? It's true.
But you can actually watch DivX videos on the Omnia, which is pretty cool. I believe it's the first U.S. carrier phone to support DivX playback. All three phones have nice screens. You know, they're pretty big. The T-Mobile, again, a little bit smaller than the others, but pretty nice. Stereo Bluetooth support across the board. Again, they've got the proprietary Samsung headphone jack on these two. The Eternity has 3.5 millimeter, which is nice. In terms of, you know, weight and size and everything, the T-Mobile is the smallest and lightest. The Omni and the Eternity about the same. So, you know, kind of in sum, I think all three of these phones, or all four really, if you include the unlocked Omnia, are solid, you know, solid touchscreen devices. And I think really the big difference here is, you know, it comes down to, people are asking me, you know, well, Omnia or Eternity, Eternity or Behold, you know, whatever. Out of the three, I mean, I think the Eternity I was struck by originally because it's not a smartphone. So you don't have to have a smartphone data plan and it responds a little bit more quickly. You can't do as much with it, but the UI on it is really pretty snappy, you know, going from menu to menu. It doesn't have the overhead that Windows Mobile does in terms of, you know, just having to process stuff. And so it jumps from screen to screen really quickly and works very well. I loaded up Qbert, bought Qbert and put it on the phone the other day. Java-based apps, you know, so you can have access to a lot of different games and other applications, that kind of thing. So since these are branded locked phones, the Eternity and the Behold, you won't necessarily be able to install all the apps that you might want to. Opera Mini, the Gmail app, I wasn't able to get those working on either the Behold or the Eternity yet. There's some hacks floating around, I believe, but I haven't gotten any of them to work just yet. But if you don't mind that, you don't mind just, you know, kind of sticking with what the carrier offers you. You know, both of these phones, a little bit snappier than the Windows Mobile phone, and the Eternity, I think, is just a little bit, you know, a little bit nicer because it's a little bit bigger. The screen is a little bit bigger, and without having to hack anything out of the box, the web browser is a better experience. But now that, you know, we figured out how to unlock the server settings, basically change the server settings on the Behold to unlock, you know, the full HTML web experience, I think that makes a big difference in terms of my opinion of the Behold. Although there's just something about the feel when I shake the Behold, I can feel the spring or whatever the vibrating mechanism inside the phone is. I can feel it kind of shake a little bit. The Eternity just feels somehow, it's lighter, but also like a little more solid. I don't know, it's kind of hard to explain. I like the feel of the Eternity quite a bit. But then for the power user, you know, the Omnia really just kind of has it all, except for a touchscreen. But 3G, Wi-Fi, Windows Mobile, Opera Mobile installed right out of the box, DivX Player, you know, it's a nice device. It doesn't have the TouchWiz and the Samsung Today screen aren't as nice of a Windows Mobile UI layer as HTC's TouchFlow 3D is, but it's definitely a start and you can definitely do some stuff with it, and hopefully there will be more and more useful widgets coming soon. And if you like the Omnia and you're not on Verizon, you don't want to go to Verizon, you can pick up the unlocked version. It's pretty expensive, but you can pick it up and you can use it with, again, either T-Mobile or AT&T. You can pop a SIM card in here. You won't get the 3G in the US, but you will get Edge and you will get Wi-Fi. So if you can live with that, you know, you can get your Omnia. Sprint users, you're out of luck. There's no TouchWiz phone for Sprint right now. The Instinct is probably the closest thing in terms of the hardware, but it runs on Sprint's kind of proprietary user interface system. So, you know, It'd be interesting to see if there's going to be a TouchWiz phone for Sprint in the near future. Anyway, there you go. Everything you wanted to know and then some about the four of the five TouchWiz phones that'll work in the U.S. I guess the F480 will also, but there's more than five. But anyway, there's the Dell for Alto, which we don't have here in the Phone Dog West studios. There's the Behold for T-Mobile. There's the Eternity for AT&T. And there are the two Omnis, the Unlock GSM and the Verizon version. There it is, your rundown of Samsung's TouchWiz lineup for the U.S. I'm Noah from PhoneDog.com. Thank you so much for watching. If you have questions, head on over to the PhoneDog forums. We'll do our best to answer them. You can answer them for each other, or we'll pass them along to the good folks at Samsung if we don't know the answers. We'll try to let you know what we can about all these phones to help you make a decision about what's right for you, or, you know, what you don't really need to buy. Anyway, thanks a lot. Till next time, we'll see you later.